Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15.6 Beta 2 has been out for the past few days. I've been using it full time on my 13 Pro Max, and it seems like it's getting better. Not only for me, but for many of you based off the YouTube community poll. At the time of this video, there's 9,800 or 9,900 votes now, and 112 comments. I've read all of those comments to give you the best understanding of what this update is like. So it's not perfect, but we'll talk about what's good and bad in just a moment. And as you can see, we're actually outside and it's raining quite a bit. So there's rain in the background, and I'm curious if you like this sort of change, maybe outside with ambient noise, with the rain falling, and maybe even lightning and some thunder as well, but we'll have to see about that. But let me know what you think about that in the comments below. Now, as far as new features and changes, this update does not have a whole lot in it because iOS 16 Beta 1 is right around the corner. iOS 16 is expected to have some major features and is only a couple days away at this point. So you won't see a whole lot of features in iOS 15 anymore, maybe some changes a little bit later, but not a whole lot. But there is a bug fix I didn't mention in the initial What's New video, and that has to do with music. So in the bottom on the dock, you can see I have Spotify, and if you were to install Apple Music, just go to the App Store, we'll go to Apple Music, we'll install that, and if you install Apple Music prior to this update, it would actually replace the overall dock icon of Spotify and sort of kick it out of the dock. Now it installs to the home screen like any other app would. So they've actually resolved that in this update. I've tested it on many devices and it's definitely resolved for me. So that's something they've fixed. It's even a problem in 15.5 and earlier. Now iOS 15.5 actually continues to be quite buggy, and I'm surprised we haven't had an update because there's quite a few touch issues. I've even heard from friends saying that they have touch issues, asking when there's going to be an update, if there's a problem, and I usually don't hear from most people about that. So it looks like it's quite buggy, and hopefully we'll have an update soon. But mostly it's touch issues and freezing, which on a good note, on 15.6 Beta 2 has resolved that issue for me. So I have no touch issues whatsoever. It's nice and fast. If I go in and out of apps, I haven't had any touch issues anywhere in 15.6 Beta 2. I did hear from one person though in the comments that did have the touch issues still. Now, whether or not they're using a screen protector and maybe the phone doesn't like that, I'm not sure. But if you're not using a screen protector, it should be resolved for most people. Now, connectivity also seems to be better in 15.6 Beta 2 compared to 15.5. 15.1 or 15.6 Beta 1 and 15.6 Beta 2 have the same modem update and basically have a very similar experience. So I haven't had any issues with connectivity with 4G or 5G. You can see here, now I'm on LTE, but switching between different towers and things seems to be much better with Beta 1 and Beta 2. So far I've had a good experience with that and haven't really heard of many issues with it. Now I did hear of one issue with Bluetooth where someone did have some issues with that and it was disconnecting for them, but they didn't say whether or not that was with AirPods or a third party Bluetooth headphone or anything else. They just said they were having disconnect issues. CarPlay continues to be an issue for some, although I'm hearing about it less and less, but it does seem to be an issue. Hopefully with iOS 16, they'll finally fix those bugs. It's been a long time since we had a stable CarPlay update. As far as Wi-Fi, no real issues there. Wi-Fi seems to be performing well, and I haven't heard from really anybody that Wi-Fi is a problem. So I looked through all of those comments, and others messaged me as well. I haven't heard from anyone. Now, the storage bug does continue to be a problem for some people. So if we go into our settings, general, and then storage, we'll let it load here and we go all the way to the bottom, and Apple purposely puts it at the bottom because it's not something you need to look at regularly. You'll see mine is currently at 9.22 gigabytes and that's pretty normal. This can vary quite a bit, go from 9 gigabytes up to maybe 18 gigabytes and then back down to 2 gigabytes. It's using that data in the background and it's sort of buried for a reason. But if you have 80 gigabytes or 150 gigabytes, like some of you are saying, if you plug it into a computer using iTunes on Windows or maybe Finder on a Mac and then just sync your device to it, that seems to clear that out. I mentioned that in the Beta 2 video, and I'll go and explore some other ways to do that in future videos if Apple doesn't fix this very, very soon. As far as the overall heat or temperature of the device, it seems to be staying nice and cool. Now, typically as we get into the summer months, it's going to get hotter, and then of course ambient temperatures are going to rise. So outside currently it's quite cool since it just started raining, but it was 90 degrees yesterday and still my phone felt quite cool. Now if you have a case on it, of course that can change and it can be quite warm, but most people are saying it stays much cooler than it did even with 15.5. so it seems to be fixed for most people. Now, you can expect it to warm up a little bit if you're playing an intensive game or you're fast charging. That's completely normal, but most of the time it will be nice and cool and it manages itself. But if you're getting the overheat message, I would love to hear from you in the comments below. Overall battery life actually seems to be a little bit improved for me. So if we go down to battery, go to battery health, you'll see my actual battery health is still 100%. And here's Coconut Battery. This is a Mac app that you can download outside the App Store and will show your overall capacity as well as the battery cycle. So you can see that here. It's a free app, so I just wanted to share it to be consistent. And yesterday I had 4 hours and 39 minutes of screen on time, 6 hours and 38 minutes of screen off time, with about 60% usage. So better than I did previously on prior betas. So I used a lot more battery with a lot less screen on time. And today so far, 3 hours and 13 minutes and 3 hours and 47 minutes of screen off time. The odd thing is, screen off time, I'm really not doing anything. So there's a lot of background activity that really shouldn't exist. So that's still a problem maybe for some people, but music is not showing up for me here using background activity. So that music bug as well could be resolved also. Now, as far as someone else's battery life, Abhishek sent in his battery life, and thanks again to him for doing that. This is on an 11 Pro Max, and he had 4 hours and 15 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 28 minutes of screen off time. So actually quite good. No issues there, getting through the day with 8 to 12 hours of screen on time, depending on his usage. So it seems like it's improving, but again, it's a beta, and if you're having issues, make sure you report that in the feedback app. Now, battery life on the iPad is okay. It does seem to be getting a little better for me. So again, here's Coconut Battery sharing my battery health. And today I've had 1 hour and 55 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 19 minutes of screen off time. I haven't used this with the screen off, but I charged it yesterday evening. So it's actually doing quite well. I'm at 65% battery and it seems to be better than it was before. So based off of this, I've only used about 30% of my battery. Maybe I could get 8 hours of screen on time, which is much better than I've been getting before with 5 to 6 hours. With the iPad, I haven't had any additional issues, so no issues with scrolling, touch, or anything else, and everything is performing nice and fast. No issues whatsoever as I go in and out of apps, use it for YouTube or anything else. So no complaints there. Battery is just the major thing with iPad. Now, overall performance seems to be quite good. On older phones, newer phones, I haven't heard any complaints, and performance overall seems to be quite good for most people. So if we go into the camera here, we'll go into photo. I don't know why it went into that, but you can see here it was nice and fast. If we go to video, everything's switching quickly, going into different apps, going into the App Store, scrolling. Everything seems to be nice and fast, regardless of the device I'm on. As far as the benchmarks, I did run them again on the 13 Pro Max. I actually ran this today after doing quite a few tasks, and the benchmarks were down a little bit. 1,711 for single core, 4,533 for multi-core. Compared to when I first installed it, it was a little bit better, but if I was to close apps and it was actually doing some tasks, I was talking to some people, so it would probably perform better if I ran it again. But it's within spec, it's doing fine and running quite well without any problems. Now, as far as iOS 15.5.1, I was really surprised we didn't see that yet. We already had it with tvOS and HomePod OS last week, and or the week before now, and so far we didn't have it this week at all. So I'm very surprised we haven't had it yet, and 15.5.1 I thought would be released to fix those touch issues. Maybe Apple's going to skip it altogether and jump right to 15.6. Since on Monday we'll have iOS 16 beta 1 to developers, we'll have it later to public beta testers probably in July around beta 2 to beta 3. Now, typically these will be very buggy, so I don't recommend installing them if you were thinking of trying that unless you have a secondary device. However, I would expect maybe a beta, not next week, but probably the following week, as Apple probably is quite busy with WWDC. So I would expect all of the different updates to iOS 16, iPadOS 16, tvOS 16, HomePodOS 16, macOS 13, and watchOS 9, all of those will be out next week to developers, but then maybe 15.6 beta 3 the following week. So I really wouldn't expect that next week, but it's possible if they want to make it very busy, not only for them, but for all of us, we could see it next week as well. Of course, as those updates are released, I'll keep you updated on YouTube with new videos and of course elsewhere on social media as well. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. Let's refresh it. We still have 9.9K votes or 9,900 votes. So thanks again to everyone who voted and 112 comments. 15% of you are on 15.6 beta 2, 74% of you are on 15.5 or older, so a public version, only 1% on 14.8 or older, 1% on 13.7 or older, and 8% on Android. Now let's take a look at some of your comments. I have my iPad below. Let's take a look at what you had to say. Abdul Razak says, I wonder if your comment sections are reliable or full of trolls with no iPhone. Every version they say the battery gets better, but in reality it got worse. The reality is, I would say it's definitely reliable as people send me their battery regularly, and not everyone has the same experience. Because one person has bad battery doesn't mean everyone does. That's why there's actually beta test programs where there's millions, if not billions, of devices where Apple can get the information and figure out what's going on. So every person, depending on whether you're running apps like Facebook usually drains a lot of battery for people, or it could be a game you're playing, or just something you're doing differently, or even you have bad cell signal in your area. It's going to vary greatly for every single person. So that's why I sort of take averages and put them together. But with this update, again, it's hit or miss, but better for me, not for everyone. Braden Davis says, I'm running iOS 15.6 beta 2 on my iPhone 13. It's been great, as it should be at this point. My battery life has been almost the same as 15.6 beta 1 for me. Can't believe it'll be the last version of iOS 15 I'll be running. It's brave running iOS 16 so early on. Jeremy Lee says, iOS 15.6 beta 2 is pretty stable on my iPhone 13, waiting for iOS 16 beta. Keep up the great work, Aaron. Thank you. Abhishek Lambo said, so far on iOS 15.6 beta 2, it has been great using it on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. No lags and freezes and battery life is good. Love all your videos, Aaron. You're doing a great job. Thank you, and thanks again for sending in all of those different battery stats week to week. Doug Thomas says, using 15.6 beta 2, pretty stable. All apps seem to function fine on my 13 Pro Max. Jordan Smith said, iPhone 13 Pro Max with no issues in the latest beta. No noticeable issues with battery or bugs. It's been great. Thomas Mailer says, iOS 15.6 beta 2 on an iPhone 13 Pro Max and no issues. Sir Nicholas says, hi, I'm using iOS 15.6 beta 2 currently on my iPhone 13. For the most part, I'm having pretty good battery life, about the same as 15.5, but I have a pretty big bug where my phone goes completely unresponsive and touch function stops. And that's what I mentioned earlier. For me, the touch function was actually fixed, but again, not for everybody for some reason. So I'm curious if you're using a third-party screen protector or something else, or just the regular screen. I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And so that's everything with 15.6 beta 2, and I'm really looking forward to iOS 16. Of course, many of us are hoping for a bunch of features such as split screen, maybe a new control center and more. Let me know what you're looking most forward to in the comments below, and of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.